Hello and welcome to Inside Science. This program is designed to make your prelims preparation easier, effective and comprehensive, and to cover those aspects or topics which are very, very important from prelim point of view. Let's start with the first issue, that is Bhima Koregaon battle. The victory pillar, also known as Run Stamp, in Bhima Koregaon village, which is located in Pune district of Maharashtra, is to celebrate the 202nd anniversary of the Bhima Koregaon battle of 1818 on January 1, 2020. In 2018, incidents of violence were registered during the celebration of the 200th anniversary of the Bhima Koregaon battle. A battle was fought in Bhima Koregaon between the Peshwa forces and the British on January 1, 1818. The British army, which comprised mainly of Dalit soldiers, fought the upper caste dominated Peshwa army. The British troops defeated the Peshwa army. Peshwa Bajirao II had insulted the Mohar community and terminated them from the service of his army. This caused them to side with the English against the Peshwa's numerically superior army. The defeat of Peshwa army was considered to be a victory against caste-based discrimination and oppression. It was one of the last battles of the Third Anglo-Maratha War, which ended the Peshwa domination. Baba Saheb Ambedkar's visit to the site on January 1, 1927, revitalized the memory of the battle for the Dalit community, making it a rallying point and an assertion of pride. The second issue is tribes in Odisha. The poor implementation of government welfare programs in the tribal areas of Odisha is affecting the tribes like Juanga and Pudi Bhuya. Actually, Odisha government is implementing the schemes like OTELP, PVTG schemes are there, Biju Swasthya Kalyan Yojana, and tribal education, especially for children, are there. Still, the implementation is very poor. That's why the issue is in news. Juanga tribe. Juangas are one of the 13 particularly vulnerable tribal groups out of the total 62 tribal found in Odisha. 62 tribals are found in Odisha. They speak Juanga, a dialect of a Munda language. They usually observe their festivals and marriage ceremony with Changu dance. Yearly marriage is a common practice among Juangas, leading to complications among children born out of young parents. So every year UPSC is asking a kind of question regarding tribe, so we should cover it comprehensively. Pudi Bhuya tribe. Pudi Bhuya is a major section of the historically famous Bhuya tribe. This tribe is majorly found in Bihar, Odisha, West Bengal and Assam. It is one of the 13 particularly vulnerable tribal groups in Odisha. The highest amount of PPTGs are number of PPTGs found in Odisha. 13 types of PPTGs in Odisha, after that Andhra Pradesh. So actually highest number in population is found in Madhya Pradesh. Highest type is in Odisha. Total 75 PPTGs are found in India, and Dhevar Commission actually was appointed to provide this PPTG related typologies. They speak local Odia language, which is pronounced differently. We are discussing about Pudi Bhuya tribe. So actually Pudi Bhuya tribe, lots of tribal are there in the main strip of development. Still some are lacking, especially they are located in some regions. And in comment box mention, actually which region of India is the most tribal dominated people. I am giving you options. Options are East Eastern India, Middle India, Northeastern India, and you can say Central India. So which region is most tribal dominated? It can be a possible prelim question. So the next issue is Ghataprabha River. It is a tributary of Krishna that flows in Karnataka. Ghataprabha has a hydroelectric and irrigational dam at Hidkal. Actually, Ghataprabha is a right-hand tributary of Krishna. This is suppose your Krishna River. Let's discuss briefly about Krishna River. Remember, Krishna is the fourth largest river in India. I am telling about India only. not about other countries. So first is your Ganga, second is your Godavari, then third is your Narmada. Don't include Indus because Indus is located in Pakistan as well. So that's why I'm telling about India. So fourth largest is your Krishna. And Krishna River originates in Maharashtra, especially the Mahabaleshwar region at Satara district. And it flows in three districts, Maharashtra, Andhra Pradesh, and you can say Karnataka. And also Karnataka, Maharashtra is the origin. And you know, you just remember that Vijayawada is a town which is also known as the largest city on the river of Krishna. And left-hand tributaries are Bhima, Dindi, Pedvagu, Haliya, Musi, Pellaru, and Munneru. And right-hand tributaries are Venna, Koena, Pans Ganga, Dudganga, Ghataprabha, Malaprabha, and Tungbhadra. We are discussing about the right-hand tributary, that is Ghataprabha. Hitkal Dam is located in Belgavi district in Karnataka in Ghataprabha River. Krishna is the second largest river in peninsular India and fourth largest river in India. I have discussed it. The largest river in peninsular India is Godavari. Guys, in comment box mention which river in South India, also known as Dakshin Ganga. So this Ghataprabha rises in the western ghats at an altitude of 1,337 meters near Mahabaleshwar in Maharashtra. Krishna River in already Mahabaleshwar, Maharashtra in Satara district. Krishna flows through Maharashtra, Karnataka, Telangana and Andhra Pradesh. Previously Andhra Pradesh, now Andhra Pradesh was divided into Telangana and Andhra Pradesh. That's why four states. And finally drains into Bay of Bengal and Vijayawada is Vijayawada. It is here and this is the largest town on the bank of river Krishna. Remember it. So this is in Zoom vision, you can watch it. So here is your Bengaluru is there. It is far away from that. After that, your cities are there. Here is your somehow Vijayawada is there, largest city. So other cities, it is not that much important. Still, you can have a look on it. So so let's move to the next issue, that is money app by RBI. The Reserve Bank of India has launched a mobile app, that is mobile aided note identifier known as money app, to help visually impaired people to identify the denomination of currency notes. The application can scan the currency notes using the camera of the mobile phone. However, the app doesn't authenticate a note as either a genuine or counterfeit. It also gives audio output in Hindi and English. The application will work on Android and iOS operating systems. It will work in offline mode once installed. Then next issue is 2020 as year of nurse and midwife as per WHO. Guys, in comment box mention where is the headquarter of World Health Organization. The World Health Organization has designated the year 2020 as the year of nurse and midwife in honor of the 200th birth anniversary of Florence Nightingale. So Florence Nightingale is famous for lots of social services, and the declaration of year of nurse and midwife. Also she was a famous nurse and social service person. Will help to strengthen nursing and midwifery for universal health coverage. Strengthening nursing will help to achieve sustainable development goals, in particular the SDG 3, which mentions ensuring healthy lives and promote well-being for all at all ages, SDG 5 for promoting gender equity, and SDG 8 for contributing to economic development. It is advisable to remember all those SDGs from all exam point of view. In prelim it can come also, and mains you can write in answers to beautify your answer and so that you have a good writing skill. The declaration will also help to endorse the Nursing Now, a 3-year campaign that is in between 2018 to 2020 to improve health globally by raising the status of nursing. So moreover, WHO is also leading the development of the first ever state of the world's nursing report, which will be launched in 2020. Let's discuss about Florence Nightingale. Florence Nightingale was a British nurse, statistician and social reformer who is also considered as a foundational philosopher of modern nursing. She was born in Florence, Italy on May 12, 1820. The year 2020 marks a bicentenary year of her birth. During the Crimean War, she and a team of nursing improved the unsanitary conditions at a British base hospital, greatly reducing the death count. Her writings sparked worldwide healthcare reform. Guys, actually reading and writing are those great hobbies actually, and it will immensely improve your personality. And if you really are preparing for civil services, whether be UPSC or any state service, then improve your reading ability and also writing skills. And it does not come before exam, just like your engineering time or medical, whatever. So it comes with years of practicing. And if 5 months to go for prelims, after prelim you can do also. If you are prepared well for prelims, then you can start writing for these 2 months especially. And especially inside secure mains is there, you can practice writing there. This Florence Nightingale was known for her night rounds to aid the wounded, establishing her image as the lady with the lamp. This title is given and please remember it. So next issue is political parties registration tracking management system, that is PPRTMS. The Election Commission of India has launched a political parties registration tracking management system, that is PPRTMS. Guys, you might have read Polity Lakshmikant very well. Guys, in comment box mention which article deal with Election Commission. The salient feature in the PPRTMS is that the applicant who is applying for a political party registration from 1st January 2020 will be able to track the progress of his or her application and will get status updates through SMS and email. Registration of political parties is governed by the provisions of Section 29A of the RPA, that is Representation of the People Act 1951. A question was asked in Mains 2017 is like that: to enhance the quality of democracy in India, the Election Commission of India has proposed electoral reforms since 2016. What are the suggested reforms and how far are they significant to make democracy successful? So let's move to the question which is asked in Prelims 2018. Consider the following pairs. The left side region sometimes mentioned in news and right side country. Catalonia, Spain. It is a right statement because Catalonia, Spain was in news in 2018. Actually, it is a semi-autonomous region in Spain. And that public protest, you can say referendum was going on that time. That's why it was in news. So, and next is Crimea, Hungary. Actually, Crimea is now part of Russia. So, it is a wrong statement. And Mindanao, Philippines, it is a right statement. And Oromia, Nigeria, it is a wrong statement. So, guys, option C is the right answer. So, whatever regions or states are there in news, recently Hong Kong protest was going on, lots of things can be asked according to that. And always the Iran-Iraq region, their cities are very, very important recently, the US and Iran war, and their cities especially are important, they can be asked, so have a look on it. The next issue is 2018 prelim question. Momentum for Change Climate Neutral Now is an initiative launched by. Options are the Intergovernmental Panel on Climate Change, the UNEP Secretariat, UNFCC Secretariat, the World Meteorological Organization. The right answer is option C, that is UNFCC Secretariat. So, a CSAT question, let's solve it. Please solve it and after that you can have a look on the answer. So, let's move to the answer. You might have solved it. So, this is actually A started a journey from here and after that B joined after 20 meter. So Then after they both together walked 10 meter. After that, A changed the direction. A moved to left, 2 meter left. After that, 12 meter, then right and reached here. After that, B moved 8 meter here to down. After that, again 4 meter. From there, B diverted to right. After that, again left. Then again right. So B's position is here. Part 2 plus 8 plus 5. So it is 15 meter. Then here you are. You can subtract 4 from 12. So it would be 8 meter. Now you apply Pythagoras theorem. So under square root of 15 plus 8. So then 15 square is 225 and 8 square is 64. If you add it, the answer is 289 square root. So answer would be 17, that is option B. In this manner, every day we will try to solve CSAT question, because CSAT is also important from prelim point of view. Thank you guys, have a nice day.